गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ पार्थेस पारेख। आई एम फिजिक्स टीचर इन एलपी सवानी ग्रुप ऑफ स्कूल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 2, यूनिट्स एंड मेजरमेंट। एंड टुडे आवर डिस्कशन टॉपिक इज 2.10, डायमेंशनल एनालिसिस एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशन। ओके, नाउ वी कैन स्टार्ट। द रिकॉग्निशन ऑफ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डायमेंशंस विच गाइड The description of physical behavior is the basic importance, as only those physical quantities, say mass, length, time, thermodynamic temperature, luminous intensity, etc., can be added or subtracted which have same dimensions. A true understanding of dimension analysis help us is deducing the certain relation among different physical quantity and checking the derivations. Yes, accuracy and dimensional consistency or homogeneity of various mathematical expression which magnitude of two or more physical quantity are multiplied, their units should be treated in the same manner as ordinary algebraic symbols. We can cancel identical units in the numerator and the denominator. So let us take one example, then you can understand better way. Okay, so shall we start? Okay, fine. So now we can test the dimensional consistency or homogeneity of equation. Here is given x equals to x naught plus v naught plus half at square. Okay, so for distance x is traveled by a particle or body in time t, which start from position x naught, it is the initial position, okay, of the particle or any object, with at initial velocity, here initial velocity is also given v naught, at the time t equals to 0, it is the beginning point, okay, and it is the beginning time, and has uniform acceleration a along the direction of the motion. Now we check the dimension of LHS side and RHS side both, then we compare it. Okay, x is measured in meter, x naught also measured in meter, v naught t, v is nothing but it is velocity of the object or particle, it is measured in meter per second. So the dimension of v naught is l t raised to minus 1, okay, and the time measured in second, so the dimensions of time is capital T in bracket, so t minus 1 and t raised to 1 is cancel out, so we get l, and half t at square is equal to, so half is a integer number, so it is constant, and a is nothing but it is acceleration. We measure acceleration in meter per second square because it is change in velocity with respect to time, so velocity measured in meter per second and time is measured in second, so meter per second divided by second, so it gives meter per second square. So the dimension of acceleration is L t raised to minus 2, and the dimension of time is t square, so t minus 2 and t square is cancel out, then we get L. Okay, so each term on the right hand side of this equation has the same dimension, so we can write on the board, then you can understand in better way. Okay, so students, let's we check dimensional consistency or dimensional homogeneity equation. Okay, so here equation is given x is equal to x naught plus v zero naught plus half at square. Okay, so x is the nothing but it is the displacement of the particle of an object, or x naught is initial displacement, we can write down initial displacement or position of an object or any particle. Here x is final position or displacement of any object or particle. Okay, and v naught is initial velocity half is integer constant
or integer number, so that is constant. Okay, and a is acceleration of the particle, and t is time. Okay, so we can check the dimensions of LHS and RHS. Okay, now students, here we check the dimensional consistency of this equation. Dimensions consistency means whether the dimensions are both sides correct or not. So let us take LHS side of this equation. So LHS side is given position x. So position is measured in meter, so dimensions of position is L. Now we take right hand side. So right hand side here is given x naught. X naught is nothing but it is initial position. So we measured in meter. So the initial position dimension is capital L in bracket. Then we have given V naught t. So V naught t is the initial velocity of the particle. Okay. So V naught means initial velocity. We measured in meter per second. So we write the dimension L into t raised to minus 1. Because meter per second, so second is going to upward, then minus 1, t is measured in second, so the dimension of time is t. Okay, now we also given half a t square. Here half is integer number, so it is constant. Now a is acceleration, okay, acceleration of the particle, so it is measured in meter per second, so acceleration dimension is L into t raised to minus 2, and the time measured in second, so the dimension of the time is t, but here is given square, so we can write square. So here one can see that in v naught t, t raised to minus 1 and t raised to here 1 is cancel out, so we can get L. And here in half a t square, t raised to minus 2 and t raised to square cancel out. Okay, so we get L. So from the both side, LHS is equal to RHS, because we get same dimension on both sides. So we can say that or conclude that dimensional consistency of this equation are possible or correct. Okay, now students, write down this example. Now we take another example. It is the page number 33, example 2.15. Okay. Now the example 2.15, we have given. Let us consider an equation, half mv square is equal to mgh. So m is mass of the body, v is the velocity, g is the acceleration due to gravity, and h is the height. So we can find out that this equation is dimensionally correct or not. So let us find out. Okay, first of all we take left hand side of this equation. So left hand side is given half mv square. Okay, so student, here LHS is half mv square. So I already told that half is an integer number, so we take as a constant, and m is mass. So mass is measured in kilogram, so the dimension of the mass is m. Okay, and v square is nothing but it is velocity. Okay, so velocity measured in meter per second, so the dimension of the velocity is meter, means measured in length, and second is meter per second, so t raised to minus 1, and here we given is square, so we take square l square t raised to minus 2. Now combine both these equations, so we get m1 L2 t raised to minus 2, that is our LHS equation. Okay, now we can define or derive right hand side equation. Okay, so RHS is equal to mgh. So m is measured in kilogram, so the dimension of m is m. G is nothing but it is the gravitational acceleration. So that is measured in meter per second square. So meter for L and meter second square is t raised to minus 2. And h is the height measured in meter. So we can take L. So combinedly we can write this equation m1 L1 into L1 L1 plus 1 2 L raised to 2 and t raised to minus 2. So from equation 1 and equation 2 we can see that both equation are dimensionally same. So we conclude that from LHS and RHS this equation are dimensionally correct. Now write down all these stuffs